And welcome today. We are going to do kind of not really a tutorial, I guess maybe kind of. Some of you might already know about doing this, and maybe some of you never gave it a thought. It just happens to be something that I started doing for probably about, I don't know, maybe a year ago or something like that. Do you ever have, you know, like a ton of mods that have a lot of settings, or maybe some of them you're able to save the settings, but it takes sometimes a while to load them in? Or maybe you just have a world like this, for instance, a custom world where it doesn't come with really any houses other than, like, this one only comes with, let's see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 houses that this one actually comes with. And as you can see, it doesn't come with any Sims. There's no Sims in here. There's, you know, there's no parks or anything hardly in it or anything like that. And it, you know, if you've ever done something like this where you had to add more houses or add households, you know, add basically the finishing touches, it can take a very long time. There's been times where I've spent a good 45 minutes probably setting up just this world right here, actually. Or maybe you like one of EA's worlds, but you prefer to have it done all in maybe your made Sims that you've done over the, you know, course of months or years, or, you know, some of your own families that you have, and, you know, just little things like that, and you just get tired of having to keep changing the settings. Or maybe you want this game, you know, to be certain settings, and maybe this other one you want to have different settings, and just the time it takes alone just to set up each game can take quite some time. So basically what I'm going to show you here is what I do to have an already ready, I guess I call it like a starter home, not really a starter home, but a starter world or whatever. Actually, I just call it new starter. I usually just title it whatever it is that I want. And basically what I'm going to show you is how do we start. We're going to take the time in putting together an actual world, and then, you know, any world that you want, even if it's EA, or maybe a different custom world, or maybe this one, which happens to be a Luna Island from The Sims Supply. I love this world mainly because look how small it is. It is really small, so it loads up really quick. It doesn't take very long for the Sims to go from one place to another or anything like that, and it runs very smoothly. So anyway, we're going to work with this world. I'm not going to show everything. I'm not going to, you know, do every single, everything that I'm going to add to it, but I'm going to do a couple. Just in case, I mean, I know when I first started playing the game, you know, years back, I did not know that you could edit a world before you started playing. So just in case there happens to be some out there that do not realize that you can before you pick a house, if you come down here, you can actually go in and edit town before you even start doing anything at all. So we'll see here. There it goes. And as you can see, there's all kinds of lots, but there's no households. There's no pre-made households put in here or anything like that. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to place all the households that you want anywhere that you want. You're going to add any of the houses. Mine takes a little while here to load because I have a lot of houses. All the ones that I've done along with other downloaded houses. You're going to place in all of the houses that you want, anywhere that you would like them to be, along with any of your community lots. Like, I even have some pre-made community lots. Just some of them that I have done over the past. Like, here's one that I had done from Midnight Falls. And then, you know, like, I even have, you know, the Luna Island Park, which goes right here. And in order for you to put that one in, just so you know, you have to delete this first, because apparently it must think it has objects or something. So you gotta delete it first, you know, erase any objects that it thinks it has, and then place down the new Luna Park. Just in case, I have seen on some forums of people having trouble placing this particular park all you have to do is bulldoze it the first time. It says, are you sure you want to bulldoze it? All the objects will be deleted. Yes, we do want to do that. So we're going to go ahead and let it, you know, let it do that. Okay, and then it's going to change it to, of course, no visitors allowed. It always does that. But you're going to need to change this. Let me see. I believe, yes, it's set for as a big park. And hold on, let me see here. I actually have one that I changed. I took it and I changed it. See if, is that the one that it is? I don't think it is because it's not the... Here it is. Here's the one I did. And as you can see, all I did to it, it's the same one I decided to pull. So it's set as a big park. So you're going to go in and you're going to change this to big park. So let's go ahead and find that. There it is. So change that lot to big park. And then you should be able to place this. This way, if you ever have any troubles with it, sometimes you have to delete that and then place it. So for whatever reason, it thinks it has objects. I don't honestly know what objects it thinks it has, but we got to delete whatever it is first, and then we can place the lot. So basically, you're going to go through any world that you have. Whether it's EAs, you know, whether you take the time to delete some of the houses, or maybe you go through and delete the families and then put your own, or whatever it is, you know what I'm saying, it takes a long time to do all the processing. As you can see, here's the lot. See, as you can see, all I did was add a pool. That's the only thing different I did, because this lot, or this this town does not come with a pool. So here's a pool for the Sims. Is all I did. But anyway, you know, it takes a long time. So go through whatever it is you're doing and set everything up. And then I will show you here in a little, you know, when we come back, I'll show you what I do. So you can always save it at the spot that you want. And you can always start a fresh game every time. And you can pick new households each time you come in, or you can make a new household each time you come in. I will show you what it is you need to do. Okay, so after you have gone through and added any community lots that you would like to have, or any of the households, or just houses in general, like I have, you know, a house here that's empty. I leave a few of them that are empty for expansion or for my beginning Sims, you know, to move into as well. But then I also have a few households, like here's a household, like this one has a lot of kids, and of course, you know, these also already have jobs, so you're not putting in, you know, if you use your own Sims that have made families and made a life somewhere else at one time and you saved them, their jobs of course will get saved with them when you take them, you know, put them into whenever you put them into whatever this is down here. I can't think of what this is down here off the top of my head today. But they get put into there, and they keep their money, they keep their family, they keep their house or their job. Now, they don't keep relationships, of course. If you move them in here and then you move them somewhere else, you know, another family in as well, they will not keep their relationships. I just would like you to keep that in mind. They won't keep them. So another thing that I end up doing is after I've placed all of my families in here, I then go through and, you know, because to me, after playing some of these families in another game for as long as some of these families I have, as you can see, this family has $2,583,000. So obviously, you know, I played that family for quite some time. In fact, if anybody watches my 100 baby challenge, they would know exactly this family when I talk about them. I had just gotten the Seasons expansion pack, actually, and I was experimenting with alien babies, and this is a family that ended up having, 12 babies all at one time. This is also the family that my alien family has come from. There's 4 aliens in this family. There's 4 more babies as well in that family. Then, of course, the alien families, I put right here. They don't have a picture of them, of course. It looks like popping up right now. But there is the alien family from that family is here. There they are. I created, I took the one alien that I had as a family member, and I took him into casts, and I turned him into females, and I turned him into children, and everything else, just so I could have more of them, and made them a family, because you can't make an alien, an actual true alien, in casts. So I had done that, and then the other one is here. And they, of course, I made one with family, with children, one without. And then, of course, their family, some of their kids had moved out. And I have them right here. So, and of course, they happen to be ghosts. And they have ghost babies. But anyway, what you need to do, I don't know if you can do this without mods or not. In fact, I have been playing this game with mods probably within a few months after I got it years ago. So I really can't tell you a whole lot on what just the vanilla game has and what you can and can't do. But you can change family in the game if you use NROS Master Controller. All you gotta do is look that up on Google and you'll find it. If you're not really too sure what it is, on my website I have a page for just mods, and it's on there if you need to look it up. But with that mod, you can go in and you can change family relations. Because since when you place them in here, of course they lose all their family ties are gone. And for me, it's the first time I played it, not thinking about that, not paying any attention. And I seen some of these Sims here dating some of the and having kids with another Sim that I knew was blood related. And to me, that just seemed really odd. So I had gone in when I had created this and I changed all my family. So now, when I come into this world to play a new game, they will have, whether or not they're cousins or aunts or anything like that, along with all of their jobs are in place, their level and their job is in place, everything else is there. So that's one thing that I like about having this kind of setup is I can go in and I can make my own town and I can make the families and everything that I would like. Plus, I know this world was created before or for base game. So if any of you have ever played in it, there isn't a fire station either. So the only fire station you have is for the NPCs that doesn't exist. So, and things like that. Like right here I put in, I guess it's called Verona County Fire Department. I don't know. It's one of the game fire departments. I didn't make it. I was lazy that day and just kind of threw it in. But, and a few of these other houses that go here, you have to download them and then put them in yourself. They don't all come with the, as you could see before, they didn't have hardly any houses. So, add your houses, add your families, change the relations if you can or if you want to. And then all you're going to do from here, because it says return, to game setup. If you click on that, once you're completely done, this will take you back to that beginning screen where you can create your household, choose or move one in. And this is where you're going to just go ahead and save and do a save as. And as you can see, this is one that I already have saved. Title it something that you know. Of course, you can't make a huge title, but as you can see, I have a Luna Island new starter. And when I see that, then I know that this is a new starter. I won't have to do anything. I won't have to change any mod settings. I won't have to import any of the settings. Everything is already done for me. I load the game up and I can start playing right away. So So now I'm going to go ahead and show you how, you know, now that I told you that you can do all your settings and change your relationship with your family, I'm going to go ahead and show you how is it exactly that I do that and then get back to this screen the way that we are now without having any families or anything like that already, you know, chosen. So my suggestion for you, when you go in to do all your mod settings or maybe just your family settings or like their jobs and, you know, getting everything finalized, what you need to do is go in, pick a household. Now this one I'm going to pick because he, you know, this is a small one. My suggestion would be is to choose a small household because as you can see this one, they don't show all of the babies, I guess they're toddlers. I don't think it shows all of them in that family, but there is more than eight. When you start getting into a lot of Sims in one family and then you start bypassing the limit of eight because of mods, they can take quite some time to be taken to the clipboard and put back in and things like that. So what you need to do is you need to choose a family in this screen here. Well, maybe that's not this screen. I'm sorry. You need to go back to game setup. I apologize for that. It's been a while since I've had to do this. Choose a household. So the first thing you're going to do is choose. Now, what I would do is save. Make sure you save your world first as a new starter world before you go and do this. So you don't have, you know, that way this part is done. And if something were to happen, you don't have to start all over. So after you've done your first save and everything is in place, go ahead and go to choose household and pick one that is small. Okay, make sure you pick one that is small. That way it doesn't take quite so long to load and things like that because there's not, it's not as big of a family. So we're gonna go ahead and, you know, wait for this to load. I don't really know how long it takes. I'm not usually paying any attention. I tend to do, you know, other things while I'm waiting for the long process. So there it goes. There we go. I went ahead and paused it that way because I do have some mods that when it uploads it, they take a little bit for the settings and things like that. Now, like I said, if you have settings to do, this is when you're going to go ahead and do it. Now that you have a family, you can go in and do all your settings. I know NROS has it where you can save all of them. You can export your savings. So go ahead. This is a time to import all of your settings for that. I do have a few other mods that have their own settings that cannot be saved at this time. There's a couple of them actually that are like that I cannot save. So this is when you'll go in and make your settings or changes to those mods. And then this is also when you're going to go in and change all the family. So now you might have to do some changing households when you do family. You know, go to this family, go to that family, and things like that in order to get the households to be correct. So if you have to do that, you know, it does take a little bit of time. Like it took me quite a bit of time even with this. So like one of the things, like even for him, he currently does not have, I don't think he has a job. I can't remember. What does he have? Yeah, okay, he's a job. See, I had created him a long time ago. He works for a custom job, the family, and I put him at level 7. So he already has a job. I don't have to set anything up for him. He does not have any family. And as you can see, he's a vampire. So at least becoming one anyway, since we just put him in. So, but, or if you have some that you want everybody to be vampires, you can change everybody, you know, at this time and make them vampires and have an entire vampire world. Or maybe you want all ghosts, or you want just maybe everybody to be normal. Like some of my families I have saved are ghosts, some are vampires, some are fairies. Maybe you don't really want to play in a supernatural world, so this is a time you can take that stuff away from them and then you can save it and everything. That way, when you want to play a world with your families that you normally have, but they're not supernatural, you'll have one already set up and ready to go for you to play that doesn't have any of that stuff. So now what you're going to do, now that you have changed all of your mod settings and you've changed any family relations, gave everybody their jobs that they need to have, put them in their levels, now you're going to need some mods in order to change their level. So like Enra's Master Controller, that changes, you can change their job, you know, put them in the level and everything that you want. You can even change their money. Like that one family I have has over $2 million. Maybe you don't want a family that has that much money, you know, in the world. I don't mind it, but maybe you don't want, you know, some of the people to have that much money. You can change their funds, you know, change how much money they have to start out and have an entire world that you want set up your way, the way you want it. So now what you're going to do to get out of the screen and go back to what we were in, you're going to go to Edit Town. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is go to Edit Town. Now as you can see, we still have this family and all we can do is return game. If you want, go ahead and save it now. That way you save all of this progress that you have done with the family jobs, the relations, everything. All your mod settings are all taken care of. Because that's a long process alone. If you have Enra's and you have as many of them as what I do, you know the painstaking process it is to go in and set all of those settings time and time again if you do not have them already imported. I eventually, you know, was able to figure out, you know, this takes so long to do, but you can save those settings. So now all I gotta do is import them, and that makes it so much easier. But I have other mods that I have to go through and change, and it just gets really tiring after a while having to change those. So this is, once you go to Edit Town, you're going to click on the family that you were, you're going to split up household, you're going to take him out, make sure you sell furniture and everything, that way he goes back to the money value that he had prior. And then of course by doing this, it's going to change your active household. He will no longer be your active household once you do this. And it's going, this is why I said pick a small family, because when you go to do this, it's going to put it in clipboard. And if you choose a family like this one that has well over 8 Sims, it's going to take, depending on how fast your computer is. Now mine's not super slow, but it's definitely not fast. There's definitely times where it could be a lot quicker. It does, you know, it is kind of slow sometimes. So, you know, I've seen other people on YouTube do some of the stuff that I do, and it goes so much quicker, and I know it's because of my computer speed. So you're going to place them back in the lot that you want them. So he's going to purchase that one. Now remember, it's not our family anymore. As you can see, it's no longer green, and we're back to return game setup. So this is what you want. Go back to return game setup, and there you go. You have now completed everything that there is. Okay, you know, all of the everything is taken care of, absolutely everything. So now this is where you're gonna go in. You can go back and save again. You know, and of course mine's titled as a new Aluna Island, or Aluna Island New Starter. And you're going to save this. Now you need to remember, when you do go to play this game, your very first save that you do, you need to do save as and give it a different title. Okay, do not forget to do that, because it will save over this, and you will no longer have an actual starter. Okay, unless you want to, you know, create a family and get a little bit more life and everything like that going, a little bit more, you know, get it a little bit more expanded and then save it, that's fine too. But if you're like me, you prefer to start off, you know, a little bit, as close to being new as possible without all the expansions and things like that and all the added extra sims. So make sure you do your first save as and give it a new title, or you will save over all of this that you just did. That is pretty much all I have for setting up, you know, a new starter world for yourself. This can be done, like I said, in any custom world. This can even be done in any of the EA worlds. And I just find this very, very time saving, just because you don't have to do all of the beginning stuff every single time. So I hope you found this video helpful, and if you enjoyed it, please let me know with comments and a thumbs up. And if there's anything else you would like me to show you how to do, any kind of tutorial, anything at all, I will be more than glad to help you out. Any questions, I will do my best to answer. And thank you for watching, and have a wonderful day. Bye.